five, six, seven, 8 hours straight. And those students, like you saw in those crowds, will gather around. They'll skip class, and then, if they don't have class one day and I'm talking to them, they come back in the next day. They're really hungry. They won't go in a lot of clubs and so forth, but they will come out there. There's something about just preaching the gospel. The Bible says that the preaching of the gospel of Jesus Christ is foolish. And he says, just beware. It's a word, beware. Now, how many of you have seen, you go to a high voltage sign and you see beware, danger, high voltage? How many of you have ever seen that, Okay, well, that means, watch out. You got to be careful. Now, he says, spoil us through philosophy. That's what's happening to the college students back there. They try to go get into philosophy and things and the love of knowledge and they think they're smarter than God is.
That's right.
That's what it is. They think they're smarter than God. They're not smarter than God.
That's right.
The only reason they got some wisdom is that all wisdom comes from above. The Bible says, if any man lack wisdom, let him ask of God, and give it to all men liberally, and bring it not, and it shall be given to him. Let him ask in faith, nothing wavering. Amen. The tradition of men. Now that would get a lot of us in church. Jesus said this in Matthew 15, you've made the commandments of God none effect by your what?
Tradition.
By your tradition. You made the commandments of God none effect by your tradition. Can I get an amen there?
Amen.
Amen. There's a lot of tradition in church. Amen. There's a lot of things that are going on that are not Bible. They're just traditions. Amen. And if they have traditions, it ought to be based on the Bible. After the rudiments of the world, that's the elements, the rudiments and so forth, the structural things of the world, rudiments of the world, and not after Christ. There are two religions, I use this all the time, there are two religions in this world. There are two systems of religions in this world. You say, no, there's more than two. There's two. How do you say, no, there's more than two? No, there's two systems of religions in this world. There's one over here by man that says, I have to do this. I have to do this, and I have to do that. Some system. You take Jehovah's Witness, they knock on the door, and they sell the Watchtower magazine. The Mormons, they ride the bikes for 2 years, they go on a mission trip. The Muslims, they bow down five times a day towards Mecca. You have Hinduism, you have Taoism, you have Buddhism, you have Hare Krishna, you have a Catholicism that says you have to keep the seven sacraments. And I could go on and on and on. You look at all the religions in the world, and they're all saying you have to do this, 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 and that. Now, they're all a little different, but they're all saying you've got to earn something. You have to work something. My good will outweigh my bad. Then there's all by itself, Bible Christianity, which just says we're all sinners.
That's right.
And we've broken God's law. Yeah. There's nothing we can do. It wouldn't work if we stood before a judge and we broke the law and we said, well, Your Honor, I'll do good from now on. He's not going to let us go.
That's right.
There's a penalty. It doesn't matter how good you are. It's the goodness of God that leads you to repentance.
Right.
And that God's work on the cross of Calvary, that God sent His only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in Him should not perish but have everlasting life. It says you can't work. We are His workmanship created in Christ Jesus unto good works. Oh, once you get saved, then you'll want to do good. Then you'll want to live right. Then you'll want to talk right. Amen? In the heart, there's no God. Okay, some of you have heard that. But you know what? The verse goes on there. The fool said in their heart, there's no God. They are corrupt. They have done abominable works. There is none that doeth. People want to say there's no God because they're corrupt, because they've done abominable works, because they love their sin. You know what you need to do? You need to give up your sin. You need to be willing to let the Lord Jesus Christ take your sin.
Now, Lord, you're able, Lord, to protect and put the angels about to just protect and undertake, Father. Lord, we look to Thee for Thy help and Thy guidance, Lord. And I pray for everyone here today, Lord, as we do go our ways, dear Father, Lord, you would watch out for us, Lord. You watch your safe and sound, Lord. Thank you.
Ephesians, Philippians, Colossians, 1 Thessalonians.
my heart that I might not sin against thee. Amen. Now there's no excuse for you. Amen.
Amen.
No excuse for us. They can do it.
Say it again, brother.
Amen. You must not do it.